Hello everyone, welcome to this webinar. My name is Aska Kiran. I am a senior school teacher and I'm working in, I'm from Chakwal, Punjab, and I have been working in government sector since 2011. And I'm also working as teacher educator of expert trainer of British Council since 2017. I'm doing a project named PELI, which means Punjab Education and English Language Initiative, which is basically being run by the collaboration of British Council and Punjab government. So every year, British Council organize a competition among the expert trainer, so for the Teacher Educator Award annually. So in 2018 and 2019, I was a runner-up of Teacher Educator Award. So their competitions are very interesting. So last time was about conducting an action research in your classroom. So I did an action research about how to create an inclusive classroom environment. And then I wrote a report on it. And luckily my report was selected as in the top five, and which is going to be published very soon. And I would like to share it in this page when it will be published. So then we also got an opportunity by the British Council to meet with Simon Borg, who gave us a workshop on the action research. And let me give you some introduction of Simon Borg, that he's a very well-known educationalist. And he is the professor of TESOL in the School of Education, University of Leeds. And he is involved, he has been involved in the TESOL for 24 years. So it was overall that action research project was a great learning experience, which I think that can benefit all the teachers around. So that's why I'm here today to share my learning of action research with you. So without any further delay, let's move to the slides.
So let me remind you for the housekeeping, please, you know, keep your microphones on mute, and chat box is open for everyone, and you can post your questions, and also you can share your takeaways using hashtag TD the webinars and connected by action. So, yeah, we are going to share the screen now from the presentation. Can you see the screen, Aska?
Yeah.
Great.
Can you please move to the next slide?
Sure.
Yeah, so these are the objectives of this webinar, that at the end of this webinar, you will be able to get familiarized with the action research and the different steps of action research and how you can get started with the action research in your classroom. Next slide. Let me have a small introduction of you. Can you please give your name in the comment box and the post on which you are working, and your city or your country, please. So, yeah, Khudri Yusuf is with us. Thank you, Zuna and Sidra and Urbanic. Sorry if I have pronounced your name incorrect. Thank you for all of you. You can comment on the Facebook page. Next slide, please. Thank you, Santosh from Nepal. Marjoy, thank you, from Philippines. Pines. Monali, thank you for joining us, and hope this session will be helpful for you in your classrooms as a teacher. So let's start our the first slide, which is the professional development. As you know that there is a very famous model of professional development, which is training model, and you are very well familiarized with that. Teachers have a major concept that you get professional development from the outside through a trainer, that you join a training room and then you get professional skills from a trainer. So this is called training model. But let me introduce you today a very interesting approach, which is reflective model. In this model, you will help yourself by your own to solve your problems without seeking help from the outside. And how you will do it with the action research. So action research is basically a research carried out by the teachers to solve their problems by themselves. But this will happen through a systematic way, which we will study later in the next slide. Next slide, Aman. Okay, you can see a word written there is professional inquiry, PI is a reflective approach, because this is an old presentation and I use professional inquiry instead of teacher action research, because professional inquiry has or action research has many names. You can say a teacher inquiry, teacher research, action research, exploratory practice or reflective practice, or you can say professional inquiry. So if I am using any word among these, it means that I'm talking about action research. So I use this slide just to remove your confusion if I'm using any other word instead of action research. Next slide. Yeah, so this is just a spider diagram of professional inquiry, just to give you a hint about professional inquiry, that it is used by the teachers and they do systematic inquiry about their own work to enhance teaching and learning. And then they can share this professional inquiry with their fellow teachers. Next slide. These are the benefits of action research, that action research can be helpful. Action research can be helpful for the teachers, for the schools, and for the learners as well. So first of all, how teachers can get benefit from the action research, like you are doing action research and how it will be benefit for you. Because if you will study your challenges deeply, you will understand and your challenges, then, and you will do a research on it, you will find the solutions. Obviously, you will enhance your knowledge on it, then it will empower you and give you more confidence, and you will be more motivated in your work. And how it will benefit school, because in the action research, you will involve other teachers and your learners as well. So when you will involve your learners, sorry, your colleagues, your teachers, then definitely they will also get motivated. Okay, so it will help in their professional development as well. And you will build a community around you. And when you will involve your learners will feel more trusted because you are involving them in the teaching process. They will feel more confident. So this is how you can imagine that this action research can be helpful in many ways. Next slide. Next slide, Aman. So yeah, this is very interesting picture which I have added just to give you an idea that teachers, when I say action research or when we read teacher research, action research, teachers think that, oh, it's something very difficult or very complicated thing, because we have a concept that research happens only in by the scientists in the laboratory. So you just don't need to be worried about this, because this is a very simple process which can be carried out by the teachers. That's why it is called teacher research. This is an organized system to answer the question we ask. It involves, so this is a cycle of action research, how it gets started. And you have to formulate the question first of all. First of all, you will observe a challenge. Then you will make a question. Then gather an information on it. Interpret this information in relation to the question. Okay. So next slide. Next slide. What is teacher research?
Aska, you're muted. You're muted, Aska.
Is it fine?
Yep. Now, go ahead, yeah.
So what is teacher research? Teacher research is the research initiated and carried out by teachers into their own teaching context to solve their own problems and issues without seeking help from the outside. This is called teacher research in a systematic way. And we will look into this very deeply in the next slide. Next slide. Yeah, these are the steps of action research. First is select a topic, then formulate a question, develop a plan, implement the plan, collect the data, analyze and interpret, and then share. So I have just mentioned the names here, but in the next slides, we will study each step in detail. So let's move to the next slide. Okay. Starting points for action research, that when you think that you should start action research, what are those points or stages in your teaching? So there are some like three indication type things or stages where you should start action research. Something that worked in your classroom and you would like to explore further. Okay, something really your students have enjoyed, you have got a very amazing result. You should explore further that what are the points or what are the things that have worked here. So this is a point where you can start action research. And the next is something you are unsure about in relation to your students' learning and your teaching. Whenever you are unsure or you are puzzled, and the next is something that is not working and you would like to improve, or you think that it is very challenging situation. I hope everyone is facing different challenges. Okay, and everyone has success stories and everyone has some puzzles about which they are unsure. So these are the starting points where you can start your action research. Next. So I would like to have your answer, that think of your recent teaching experience and tell that when you were pleased, when you were unsure, and when were you unhappy. Can you share your answer in the comment box? Anytime. Any of your experience in your teaching, when you were unhappy, you were unsure, or you were pleased, you can share your answer in the comment box.
Amita Anwar says action research is a cyclical process. Yes, it's true. And
you can share when you were unhappy, what your students did or what did not go well in your classroom that it made you unhappy or pleased or unsure, anything. I was pleased when student could come up with good paragraphs. Sorry, I missed the comment.
Yes, I was pleased when a student could come up with
react and answers. Paragraphs. Very good.
Anuradha says, I was pleased when students practice. So yeah, practice makes you happy. I'm pleased whenever my students participate actively in the class.
Yeah, definitely. It's a very, very, very common thing that teachers get happy when their students get participated well.
Tanya says, so, I'm unsure about how or where to start. You know, identify the problem.
Yeah. Okay. Identify the problem.
So what would you suggest?
Yeah, Tanya, you can do exploratory action research. That explore, if you are unsure that what kind of problems you have and on what kind of problems you should start action research, you can do explore first. You can give different kinds of questions related to your material, your teaching methodologies, or classroom environment or students behavior in the questionnaire, and then give these questionnaire to your students. So you will get very different kind of response from your students. Maybe they are unhappy with many things which you need, which will make you think to change something in your teaching methodology or your material or anything. So great. I would like to suggest exploratory action research. Explore first and then make plan on it and then execute that plan. Thank you for all your responses. Let's move to next slide. Okay. So issues in my classroom. So every one of you have shared very interesting and different issues in your classrooms. And these issues are not only related to your teaching methodologies. These issues can be related to your classroom management. Maybe your students, you have a very big classroom. I mean, you have a large number of students in your classroom. You are not able to manage them well. Maybe you have not proper furniture in your classroom. So these problems can be related to your classroom management. These issues can be related to your appropriate material. Maybe your students are not happy with your material, or maybe your material is not up to the level of your students, your students are not interested in them. And then particular areas of teaching, maybe you need to change your how you are delivering your lesson, delivering new information, or maybe your student need a better feedback from you. So there are different types, and then student attitude. So your problems can be related to these four areas. Next slide, Aman. So you should not make a mind that your problems must be related to your teaching approach, etc. It can be related to anything. You can take anything which bothers you, okay? About which you are unhappy, you are unsure, or you are happy, you want to improve. It can be anything. Next slide. Okay. So the first step was to choose a situation which you have chosen already. Then formulate a question. You have chosen an issue. Then how you will make that problem into a research question. So I have included some examples. Like first is, I have too much homework to mark. It is impossible to give effective feedback to everyone. This is an issue. And you might have, many teachers of you might be facing this issue. How you will make this into, how you will make this into, convert this into a research question? You can make it a research question as, how can I provide feedback to my students effectively? What different forms of feedback can I use? And the next example is, not all the students participate due to large number of students. You can formulate a question, research question, how can I engage the students in group work activities to enhance the participation? So these are a few examples of issues which you can formulate or change into research question. Next slide. Yeah, I have added a very interesting picture here. This picture has been made by 9 years old student. This is about good teacher and bad teacher. So you can see, and then I will tell you that why I added this picture. You can see bad teacher. So this is a student perspective, how she is seeing what bad teacher is doing in the classroom and what good teacher is doing in the classroom. Bad teacher is not involving her students. She is not, using different modes of giving new information, not using AVAs, not using activities. And she is a very authoritative kind of, and teach students are not interested in what she is teaching. But good teacher is involving her students. You can see students are very happy participating actively. They want to answer, they want to participate. And teacher is very active, very well planned. It seems that she is very interested and very concerned about the students' interest and needs. She is using blackboard, whiteboard, and pictures. And so this is a good teacher and bad teacher. And why I used, just to show you that what students want to see you. Okay, you can, if you are not sure that the points where you should start action research, you can ask to draw this kind of picture to your students. You can get a hint that what your student want you to be. So when you will ready to see student perspective, definitely your students are going to enjoy your teaching then. So this is how you can be a good teacher. Okay, you can shift from this picture to this picture if you will, you are interested in your student perspective. So in the action research, definitely you have to involve your students. The next is plan and act. This is the next slide. Or you have missed, yeah.
Yes.
This
yes.
is reflection. Mm-hmm. Just to revise whatever we have gone through in the previous slides. These are the puzzles. You can guess these puzzles in the comment box. Okay, share your answer.
Yep.
In the comment box. These all puzzles are related to action research.
Mm-hmm. So action research is?
Teacher. Yeah, yeah, first teacher. Is teacher led.
Teacher led.
Curriculum, yeah, try something else. It starts with C, but it is not curriculum. You can try another. Classroom based. Yeah.
Great ideas.
Yeah, classroom based. Thank you for your answer, Rosina. Focused on learning. Someone answered the four puzzle inquiry based. Yeah, very right. Care. Yeah, it can be care. Very interesting. Focused on learning cycle. Yeah.
Manoj,
well, every all answers are very related to action research. Lesson planning.
Manoj Kumar from
yeah, it can be lesson planning engaged. Too. Engaged, yeah. Very good. Thank you for your answers, Mushtaq, Ahmed, engaged, yeah. Thank you, everyone, for your active participation in the comment box. Let's move to the next slide. So you can, your all answers are right and very related to action research. Okay, the next step is plan and act. Once you have identified your challenge or your issues, then you have formulated a question, research question. Then the next stage is plan and act. You can talk to your colleague here as well. You can both work together, plan different activities, and then execute this plan into your class. Okay, you can add here different activities, different integrated technologies, posters, games, etc. So this is the second stage, which is very important. And that's why it is called action research, because this is where you plan and you make action. And you can use a variety of things. You can experiment new things here. This is totally your laboratory. Your classroom is your lab where you can perform different experiments. And this is a stage, plan and act, where you can do anything. This is experimental stage. Next slide. Collecting information data. Yeah. The next, when you have executed plan, the next step will be to gather information and data. Here you have to use different data gathering tools, like face-to-face interviews. You can talk every student individually, and you first of all you have to make some interview questions. Okay, what you want to know about the activities which you have performed in the previous step. This is called face-to-face interview. The next is focus group discussion. You can do focus group discussion as well. When you have a large number of students, you can't go to face-to-face to interview to each student, because there are large number of students. You can have a focus group discussion. You can talk to randomly, you can choose 5 to 10 students, and then you can talk to them. This is called focus group discussion, but it should also be very well planned. Then sample of student work, very good. This is that you have performed, your students have performed some work on worksheets, or you have given them some projects in the previous step. So you can use it as a sample work, that before these plan or activities, they were not able to do this, but after this, they have made this project. Very well done. Then self-observation. This is very important, because you can make audio or video recording of yourself, you performing in the classroom, and then observing later. And then you will notice many things that you are doing wrongly in your classrooms. Then the questionnaire, you make questionnaire, distribute among the students, and then observe it. Or survey forms can be used, reflective notes, reflective journal. Shor mat karein. This is, what is reflective notes or reflective journal? That after the lesson, you will note down what went well and what did not went well. So this is called reflective notes. Peer observation. You can ask your colleague to come into your classroom and then observe your lesson and observe student behavior, how they are participating, if they are happy, if they are answering according to the activity. This is called peer observation. These are the data gathering tools which you can use after performing, after executing your plan. Next slide. Next is analysis and interpretation. Once you have gathered the information, the next thing is to analyze that data, because analysis generates results. Finding, let's suppose you carry research on 40 students or 45 students, and you say that 40 students participated well, but 5 students did not participate well. This is called your result, which is based on your data. And then you will interpret this data and make a conclusion. Okay, why they participated well? Because you did this. You introduce pair and group work. So it means that it can be helpful to enhance their participation. This is called interpretation of data, which leads towards conclusions. Next slide. Oh, this is very interesting, that presenting results. Results are those things which you have, for which you have used data gathering tools, okay? That 30 students did this and 2 students did not participated well. So this result can be presented in many different ways, like tables, journal extracts. You can write down in the journal and then you can show it in your research, then graphs, then quotations, that if your students have said something and during the interviews, you can use their sentences or quotations in the in your action research. Then you can use pictures, which is very common and easy way, then posters, and then you can also go to write your report. But it all depends on you. If you don't have time to write the report, then you can just share your findings verbally with your teachers or with your colleagues, or you can write in your own way, like in whatever you feel comfortable or you it's easy for you. It's not must that you should write report, okay? You can use any method which is easy for you. The next slide. Reflect. Once you have completed your action research and you have concluded something from your research, the next step is to reflect. Reflect on what was surprising or new for you and how did it change your perception and assumption. Okay, this is very important. If something is very surprising or something you think that it went very well in your classroom, you need to practice on it. You need to adapt it. You need to make it your habit. Okay, so how you will do it, you will perform it again and again in your classroom. This is called practice after reflection. And if you think that something is not good for your student and you are doing it in your classroom, then, but it's your habit. So again, you need practice to remove it. So the next slide. Sharing and communication. Okay, once you have done your action research and it went very well, the next thing is sharing your finding with other teachers. It will be very helpful if you want to share your findings with other teachers, because it will motivate other teachers as well. So there are two ways to share your research with others. One is non-digital and other is digital. Non-digital ways are presentation and written reports. Presentation, you can give poster presentations or on your computer or on the projector with your colleagues or your fellow teachers from the other schools as well. Or you can share your written report with them. Okay, anything written or you can share with them. And digital ways are which is very easy nowadays. You can write blogs and newsletter, and you can use social media, Facebook, WhatsApp, YouTube. You can write something like few lines or a paragraph and then share it with your teachers. And you can add pictures that, hey, I did this and it went very well. So I'm sure that it will help your colleagues to, you know, to adopt these things. Next slide. Trustworthy. Okay. And define the purpose clearly that when you have, before starting the action research, you should have to, you need to define the purpose that why you are doing this action research, why you are taking pictures, why you are giving questionnaire, because students will be, you know, will maybe they are shy or they will be surprised that why you are getting their information. So you should tell them the purpose. Okay, maybe they, if you will not tell, maybe they will hide their information. So you need to be very clear. Just give them the purpose. And if you are involving your colleague teachers, you should give them a clear purpose as well. Then adapt the systematic method. You have seen the different steps. Okay. One by one, you need to follow these steps, and then different data gathering tools, and then different methods of presenting your results. This is a systematic method because it will make your report more solid and more trustworthy. Then design and choose specific data gathering tools, which we have already discussed, and provide evidences. Yeah, it's very important. You need to, collect evidences when you are performing, like take the pictures and preserve or, you know, save some of work of your students, some worksheets or some projects, or some, you can also take, audio and video recordings as well. And you can show these recordings to your colleagues. And be critical. Yeah, you should be critical. It's a very important point. Like, you can't say that if something went well, you did group and pair work in your students, you have introduced this group and pair work because your students were not participating well, and you have given them group and pair activities, and it went very well. You can't say at the end that all credit goes to group and pair work, that yes, group and pair work is very best and it enhances student participation. No, you can't say this. Maybe when you perform the activities, maybe it was the first period of that day. Maybe students are already very active. Maybe you have chosen the topic which is very interested for the students. So there are many factors which can be involved in that result. So you can say that group and pair work make or increase the effectiveness or increase the participation, but you can't give all 100% credit to group and pair work. So this is called be critical. Next slide. This is end? Okay, yeah. Last slide, ethics. Take consent. Yeah, before starting the action research, take consent, because you are going to take the pictures, you're going to record the videos and audios, and you are also going to take some written information, any kind of information you are going to take from the students there. Okay, so you are going to take the consent first. Avoid harm. Don't do such activities which can harm your students, or mentally or emotionally, any kind of. Then maintain confidentiality, yeah. Maintain anonymity. Yes, when you are going to write the quotations of your students, don't use their names, the real names. You can say any XYZ. And this data is very confidential. Don't just make them sure that you will save them. You're not going to share them. Thank you. This is the end. You can ask any question in the comment box. And thank you.
If you have any questions, you can post in your comments box. And thank you, Azka, for your wonderful presentation. And thank you, everyone, for joining us. We'd also like to thank, especially thank Master English Training for sponsoring our Zoom Pro account. And as you know, teacher development webinars is a volunteer project, and we do not have much funds. So Master English Training were generous enough to sponsor us with this Zoom Pro account. And yeah.
Okay, someone has asked that can I please share the references of this presentation. I have made this presentation after strong presentation of Simon Borg. I think I have introduced Simon Borg, that Simon Borg is a very well-known educationist from the UK, and he is a professor of TESOL, and he's working in the School of Education, University of Leeds, and he's working, involving in the TESOLs for 24 years. And he was here in the Pakistan to give us a workshop, 2 days of workshop on action research. So he gave us presentation, and I collected this information from his, his books and all the material which they provided us before starting action research, before the competition. So I can share the presentation slides with you as well, if you want, in the comment box later.
So yeah, we'll be, sharing these slides in the teacher development webinars group. And meanwhile, you can join and follow our social media channels.
We forgot to add feedback link.
Mm-hmm. So do you mind sharing complete?
I did not create it.
David said, thank you very much for sharing such an amazing and fantastic presentation.
Thank you, Darwin.
Very meaningful, and
for joining.
Yeah, great. So thanks, everyone. I think, we should end it up here. And if you are interested in presenting in teacher development webinars, so we have call off proposals open. You can go on teacher development webinars. Great. So thanks, everyone, for joining us. And it was great to have you all. If you are interested in presenting in teacher development webinars, you can apply for any presentation you want, and it's an initiative to support the teachers.
So, Muhammad Behban Aman, someone has asked a very interesting question, that sometimes the problem is how to adopt the systematic method. Could you specify a tool to help? So it's not very difficult. Maybe you are thinking research word is related to, that's why I added the picture in which a scientist was working in a lab, because we have concept that it's very complicated, very difficult, but it's not. Okay, you just need to think on which you want, when you are unhappy, when you are pleased, when you are unsure, and you want to know the reason, you can start your action research. Just make a question and then use some data, make a plan, execute that plan, and then use some data gathering tools like interviews, questionnaires, surveys, and then present the result in the form of some graphs or tables, etc. It's very simple.
Are there any more questions? So I think, we're done for the day. And to wrap it up, to end the session, I would like to thank our audience and a wonderful presenter, Ms. Azka. And thank you, Azka, for presenting action research in
Thank you
this much
for
great
having me.
great manner, and follow us on Twitter,
Thanks
Facebook,
to all
Instagram.
Of the beautiful people who have commented and who have joined us today. And thank you, Aman, for giving me this opportunity. It was a great, great thing today. It was a great time. Thank you.
Yeah.